Okay, Kushalin Jagrat, I was just going through the vocabulary and I think it is a little difficult whenever we talk about the vocabulary. And if the teacher is going to judge you on the basis of the literature part, then this chapter will hold an important place. So be very attentive and make sure you write down the new vocabulary you come across. The heading of the chapter is Se Ma Vi. Vill, Se Ma Vi. Ville means the city. I am talking about my city. This is my city. This is the title of the chapter. Ville, the new word for you, it's city. Sophie et Marie sont cousines. Sophie et Marie sont cousines. Sophie and Marie are cousins. Elles se rencontrent après longtemps. Elles se rencontrent. Rencontre means when you meet someone. So they are meeting each other after a very long time. They are two cousins, Sophie and Marie, who are meeting each other after a very long time. Marie et three arras. Arras, HEURUSE. Arras means when someone is very happy. It's an adjective. Marie et three arras. Marie is very happy. The voir, Sophie. Voir verb we have done before. Voir means to see someone. So Marie is very happy to see Sophie. Sophie habite à Lyon et Marie vient de Paris. So Sophie, where she lives, where elle habite à Lyon, she lives at Lyon. And Marie vient de Paris. Marie is coming from Paris. Pour, P-O-U-R, very important preposition. P-O-U-R, pour means for. Pour passer ses vacances chez Sophie. To pass her vacations at the place of Sophie. She, we did in class 7th. She, C-H-E-Z means at the place of someone. So, she, Sophie means at the place of Sophie. So, she is coming from Paris and they are going to stay chez Sophie. Sophie montre et décrit sa vie Lyon à Marie. So, if you remember, when we did the first and zero chapter, the conversation between two people was about Paris and France. Right now, they are going to describe the city Lyon to Marie. Voyons la ville de Lyon avec Sophie. See the city of Lyon with Sophie. Any doubt? Any word or verb?
Mom.
Okay.
Can you explain the second last sentence? Sophie Montreux,
हाँ,
like what is it?
सोफी मॉन्ट्र ए देक्री सा वी लियों आ मारी. सोफी मॉन्ट्र, मॉन्ट्र मीन्स टू शो, लाइक इफ समवन इज कमिंग टू माई कंट्री, माई सिटी, सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेक देम अलॉन्ग एंड शो देम डिफरेंट प्लेसेस. सो सोफी मॉन्ट्र शोज एंड डिस्क्राइब हर सिटी लियोन टू मारी. मॉन्ट्र इज टू शो. Okay, so they have given us a short dialogue between two people. First says, Salut Marie, comment ça va? Hello Marie, how are you? Bienvenue. Bienvenue is a greeting, it's a salutation. Bienvenue means welcome. Bienvenue dans la magnifique ville de Lyon. Welcome to the beautiful city of Lyon. To which the other person, that is Sophie or Marie, replies, Salut ma chérie. Ma chérie means dear. Thank you. Hello, my dear. Je me sens très bien ici. I'm feeling really good here. Je me sens, when someone feels something, the verb is sentir. We have done S-E-N-T-I-R. So, je me sens très bien ici. I'm feeling very good here. C'est une ville pittoresque. Pittoresque is picturistic. Something which, you know, we feel like, oh, it's very beautiful. We should take the picture of it. So, we call it pittoresque in French. So, hello, my dear. Je me sens très bien ici. I am feeling very good here. C'est une ville pittoresque. It is a picturesque city. So, to which Sophie replies, Oui, tu as raison. Tu as raison. When someone is correct, so in French we say, Oui, tu as raison. Basically, it means you have a reason. You are correct, whatever you are saying. C'est une destination idéale pour les touristes. This is an ideal destination for the tourist. Car il présente une variété de monuments, de beaux endroits et une cuisine délicieuse. Long sentence, so we'll break it. First part we already understood with you are Reza. Yes, you are correct. Setyun destinatio ideal. It is an ideal destination. It is a good destination for the tourist. Car, C-A-R, car doesn't mean car. Car means because. Okay, car is vatyur. Car, C-A-R here means because. Car el present yun variete the monument. It presents the variety of monuments. The Beau Androa means amazing, good, what do we say, beautiful places. Ayun cuisine, delicious, and the delicious cuisine, the delicious food. Ulala se tre antar hisa. Je veux voir cette vie avec toi. Now, what is ulala? Ulala is wow in French. When someone wants to say, oh, wow. So, we don't say wow. We say ulala. Ulala, c'est très intéressant. It is very interesting. Je veux voir cette vie avec toi. Veux, V-E-U-X. It's the conjugation of verb vouloir. I want to see this city with you. To which Sophie replies, oui, bien sûr. Yes, obviously. Mama et papa nous attendent à la maison. Allons-y. Okay. Mama et papa, mother and father, nous attendent. A-T-T-E-N-D-E-N-T. Attend means when you are waiting for something. Okay. So, mama et papa are waiting for us at the house. Allons-y. Now, here we are seeing why. So, why is like a pronoun in French which is used to replace the destination. Here they are saying, oh, let's go there. So, allons-y, let's go there. So, E here refers to the maison. Yes, obviously, mama and papa attend pour nous. That is, they are waiting for us at the house. Allons-y. Oui, je suis très excité de rencontrer tes parents. I'm very excited to see your parents. On va chez toi à pied et tu me dis quelque chose de ta vie. On va chez toi. We are going to go to your place à pied. À pied means by foot. Okay? By walking basically. Et tu me dis quelque chose de ta vie. Et tu me dis, you tell me. Quelque chose means something about your or about your city. Lyon, c'est la deuxième plus grande ville de la France. Lyon is the second most big city of France, deuxième, second most big city of France. Il y a plus de 40 musées et théâtres qui offrent diverses attractions culturelles. There are more than 40 museums and theaters that offer us to see the various different diversical attractions, various monuments, various exhibitions, various museums, which represents the culture of the city, Lyon. Just take a minute, read, go through it. In case you have a doubt, let me know. Just go through the whole page. Any word, anything you did not understand, just let me know. Okay, now they continue. After saying that, Marie says, très bien, et quelles sont les fêtes ici? Very good. And what are the festivals here? Fête, F-E-T-E-S. Fête means the festivals. Très bien. Et quelles sont les fêtes ici? What are the festivals here? La fête de Lumière est très célèbre à Lyon. La fête de Lumière, L-U-M-I-E-R-E-S. Very important word. Lumière means lights. Okay. The festival of lights, it's very popular in Lyon. Elle se déroule en décembre. Se déroule, S-E-D-E-R-O-U-L-E, déroule means when something takes place, when something happens. So this festival happens in the month of December. On décore sa maison avec les guirlandes. On décore, we decorate the house, one's house, avec les guirlandes. Guirlandes, people, you must be knowing, on Diwali, we put the lights and all, no? Bulbs, electric bulbs and all. So, what we put in India, what we put in on Diwali, they put it on the festival of lights. We call it as electric bulbs and all as guirlandes. So, this was their festival. So, where Sophie told that the most celebrated festival here is festival of lights, which takes place in the month of December. And we decorate our house with the electric bulbs. So, Marie in reply says, quels sont les monuments ici? What are the famous monuments here? Il y a la cathédrale Saint-Jean. There is a church. Cathédrale is a church of Saint-Jean. Il y a l'église Saint-Bonaventure. Okay, so cathédrale and église are the synonyms. Both of them means church. Église is also a church. Qui est une église gothique du 24e siècle? La basilique de Fouvrière et le théâtre Guignol sont aussi des lieux célèbres à Lyon. Okay, this is according to the NCERT syllabus we study in class 9, that what is la basilique de Fouvrière et le théâtre Guignol. Théâtre Guignol is like a play which takes place through in Hindi, if I say it's Kathputli, all those with threads and all, you understood, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh. So, the Theatre Guignol is a theatre which takes place through that pattern. And the Basilique de Fouvrière is an ancient kind of monument. And Gothic is like a kind of, a religion thing going there from the 14th century. Siècle. So this is more of like a history thing related that what all monuments we have there. Quel est le plus ancien musée ici? Yes, Kushal.
Ma'am, did I send it you the syllabus of half yearly and all?
Haha, I have it.
Ma'am, for all the exams or only all?
No, you sent me for all the exams.
Okay.
Okay, quel est le plus ancien musée ici? What is the most ancient museum? Musée is museum. Le musée africain de Lyon est l'un des plus anciens de la ville. So, musée africain, there is an African museum in Lyon, which is the most ancient, one of the most ancient museum of the city. Est-ce que tu sais? Est-ce que, Kushal and Jagrit, this is what, you know, we were doing. Est-ce que tu sais que Lyon est célèbre pour son industrie de la soie traditionnelle? Ici, nous avons beaucoup d'industrie de la soie et de la textile. Textile de haute qualité. After that, it's written, aussi, Lyonnais sont sympathiques et chaleureux. C'est une bonne expérience. Okay, so this is like a long text. First, it's written, est-ce que tu sais? Est-ce que is basically, is it that you know that Lyon is célèbre? Just a second. Est-ce que tu sais? Is it that you know that Lyon is célèbre? Célèbre when something is famous. Célèbre pour son industrie de la soie traditionnelle. Lyon is famous for its industry of soie. Soie, S-O-I-E. Soie is silk, traditional silk. Here we also have a lot of industries for silk and textiles. The haute qualité. The haute qualité, which is of high quality, good quality. Aussi les Lyonnais. Lyonnais is like if people live in India, so I will say Andean. Right, so it's like the nationality. Les Lyonnais sont sympathiques. They are very sympathetic. Et chaleureux. Chaleureux are the people who are very, you know, warm. They give us a warm welcome. Chaleureux. C'est une bonne expérience. It is a good experience. C'est vrai. So Marine returns, c'est vrai. Je veux voir cette ville. Is it true? I would like to see this city. Okay, just take a minute and go through it once again. Yeah, so this was the chapter. Now, do one thing. There are two questions. Répondez aux questions suivantes. Nommez l'église à Lyon. You have to write the name of church. Combien de musées et de théâtres y a-t-il? Combien de means how many? How many museums and theaters are there in Lyon? Then you have to donner le contraire. Contraire is opposite. Haut, H-A-U-T, is height, high. Sympathique is someone who is very sympathetic, who is very kind, and ancien is old. Okay, I'm giving you around 5 to 7 minutes. Read the text again and then do these questions. We'll discuss. Okay, we'll just quickly discuss it. The question says, nommez les églises à Lyon, name the church, name the cathedral, name the église à Lyon. So for this, you are going to refer this paragraph. Il y a la cathédrale Saint-Jean, il y a l'église Saint-Bonaventure. So first we have la cathédrale Saint-Jean, second we have la église Saint-Bonaventure, and third we have is the église Gothique. There are three responses for it. Cathedral Sonchin, L'Église Saint Bonaventure, and une église gothique. The three responses. Combien de musées et de théâtres y a-t-il à Lyon? So for this, we are going to refer, what is the question? Combien de musées et théâtres?
Mom, same paragraph.
Hmm?
Last line. Mom, same paragraph. Last line. Mom, four.
No, Kushal, it's this one, no? Il y a plus de 40 musées et théâtres qui offrent divers. Arif, that's what you wrote or something else?
Yeah, ma'am, I wrote 40 plus.
Il y a plus de 40 musées et théâtres. You can skip the part qui offrent divers till that also works. Okay, then it says donner le contraire. When it becomes to contraire, it means we have to write the opposites. So, haute means something which is in height, high. So, the opposite for that is basse, B-A-S-S-E. Because bon means good, beaucoup means a lot, which is not the opposite. So, it's basse, haute and basse. Sympathique, it's very simple, antipathique, sympathique, antipathique. Sympathique is someone who is kind, antipathique is someone who is not kind. Célèbre is famous, traditionnel is traditional, which doesn't correspond to sympathy. Third is ancien, the plural form. Now we have three, délicieuse, modern, and différent. So it's going to be modern. Ancien is something which is ancient, modern is something which is very modern. Delicious is delicious, différent is différent, so it's simple. So ancien, modern. So for A part, aut, it's bas. For B part sympathique, it's antipathique. And for C part ancien, it's going to be our modern. So this was our literature for this chapter. Just a second.